before the video starts, real quick, I just want to drop something for y'all. Without commitment, you'll never start. And without consistency, you'll never finish. See, the hardest part for a lot of people is just to start. And the thing that we forget is you don't have to be great to start, but you have to start in order to be great. So I say that this applies to anything in your life. And this is stuff that I speak into myself. So I can't be successful on posting my YouTube, building my channel, if I'm not committed. And I can't be successful if I'm not consistent with it. Anything that you do in life, anything that you want in life, you have to commit to it and you have to be consistent. Consistency always pays off. Always pays off. So that's a little jewel for y'all before we start this video with this haircut. Because what you're going to see in this haircut is a bunch of consistency in my guidelines and a bunch of commitment that it took for me in order for me to learn this technique. So I hope y'all love it. Hope y'all enjoy. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe. Turn those notifications on because we're coming with bangers. Man, what's up, y'all? It's your boy Bones to go back in the building. Drop another banger on y'all. This cut, I'm doing a skin fade. By the mid-skin fade, the blend on this thing gonna be real tight. As you can tell, my boy ain't had a cut in a minute. I think he was actually trying to grow his hair off for a little bit, so we were just doing, like, little shape-ups or whatnot for, like, the past few months. But he came in today, was like, bro, like, deuce, give me something, bro. I need to look clean. So I started the cut with the idea of just doing, you know, a simple mid-skin fade. But then as I began to fade, I was like, damn, this is kind of hard. You know, let me go ahead and take it up a notch and just do the whole haircut, clip over comb. So I use absolutely no guards the entire haircut. I repeat, the entire haircut. So what I do first is I like to go in with my half guard with the Gamma Stylecraft Ergos open. And just go up like right beneath, about a half an inch above the ear. I don't like to go too high with these fades because that transition area, right where the hair starts to lay flat to start sticking up, is the most important part. That can either determine whether your haircut's going to be an eraser top or that blend going to be nice and smooth. So I'm just going in right now. Pretty much what I'm doing is just debulking. Whenever you see me going horizontal with my comb, it's strictly just to remove bulk. That's all I'm doing. I'm just trying to set myself up for the next steps that I'm going to do to fade this thing out. Clip over comb for me is and was a game changer. It was extremely intimidating at first, but it was just something that I just really fell in love with. I'm all about efficiency, and I feel like me doing this type of haircut and having this type of technique in my arsenal ain't gonna do nothing but make my haircuts come out even better, save me more time. And in our industry, time is money. We don't get paid to check in or to clock in. We get paid by how much we work. And I don't charge for haircuts. I charge for my time. So if I can knock 10, 15 minutes off of a haircut with me just having a skill like this set, I feel like it's worth it, and I'm willing to put the time in to figure out and perfect that craft. So what I'm doing right now is I'm easily starting to, you know, set myself up for the next area of the fade. It's pretty much just going in and correcting all those little dark spots within the fade and just making sure everything comes out nice and smooth. Again, I am Bones the Goat on Instagram. If you can, you know, follow me on there. At B-O-N-E-Z, D as in dog, A as in apple, and then goat like the animal. I'm an owner of this barbershop. I've been cutting for like 13 years, and it took me, I want to say, 10 years for me to even hear that doing a fade like this, like all clip over comb, was even possible. The first people I ever seen do this, the first person I ever seen do it was Famos. He's based out of Winnipeg, Canada. He's a really close friend of mine. And then the person who taught me how to do it is Andes Head Educator Kenny Duncan. He's based out of Philly. And when I first started with this technique, I would suggest that you definitely put a one guard on there just for like a safety net. So just in case that guard, if the clipper does slip off that comb, I would rather hit that hair with a 1.5 or a 1 close than to hit it with a half or have the guard completely closed or the clipper completely closed and you hit it with a bald spot. It's always better to cut at least amount of hair as possible than to cut too much. Because you can always cut more hair, but you can't put that hair back on once that's gone. Once it's gone, it's a wrap. Chalk it to the game, it is what it is. You're going to see me going through trying a lot of different clippers out in here. Shout out to Gamma for sending me this package. I just wanted to, you know, go in there and see how those clippers cut with that texture of hair and see if I'd be able to use it for further, for future clients. As you can see, the fade is definitely starting to come together right now. I'm not even worried about the ball line. The ball line is going to be something that I focus on at the end of the fade. I always feel like if you don't put a hard line in, you ain't going to have a hard line to take out. So I'm coming in right now, just trying to give the haircut some type of shape. Give it that box look all the way around. you know, kind of uniform it out as much as possible with my flat top comb. You can see the dark spots in there. Now I'm just gonna start really, really just going in with the corner of my blade and just teasing, you know, teasing those little dark areas, going in with my comb whenever I see need be. This haircut is definitely, this technique is definitely something that I would consider to be an advanced style of cutting, because you have to be completely confident that if you do get too deep in this haircut, that you can pull out your guards and kind of fix it. I do not use all clip over comb on every single of my haircuts. I do use guards, but I just wanted to get on here and show you guys that it is capable, it is possible for you to do these type of haircuts with just a comb. And the time where I learned that I could do this is I had a house call from my good friend Andre Durrell, professional boxer. I had to cut up his son, and I was in a rush from work. It was a late house call, so I rushed over there, and I get there, and the only thing I had was that black comb that you see in this video and my clippers. I completely forgot all of my guards. It was 9 o'clock. His son was like, I want to say 9 or 10 years old at that time, so I definitely did not have time to go back to the shop and grab my guards. I had to figure it out. And thankfully, from the stuff that I learned from watching Famos, watching Kenny, and then me just honestly just practicing on my own, I was able to get that haircut to the same quality that it would have been if I had a pair of guards. And from that point on, I was like, I have to implement this technique into my everyday schedule, my everyday routine with my clients. So now what I'm doing is I'm coming in with my gammas and just ball, knocking off that ball line. Because the top is, for the most part, pretty faded out. You know, obviously we're going to go back and hit our detail work in there. But as you can see, I'm not really, for the most part, putting no hard lines in there. I'm flicking up like I got a pair of adjustable clippers, like I'm using my Ergos or I'm using my Masters. I try to really stay away from putting those hard lines in their hair, especially when I'm removing a lot of bulk like a client like him. I'd rather just, you know, take care of those fade from the top and work my way down. I feel like that just gives me the better overall look for the most part. Shout out to my boy Steve too. He came in early for his cut and thugged it out. I told him I was shooting this video. You know, I'm going to be over in about 10, 15 minutes. Shout out to my dog Steve, man. My plug right there, man. That's my dude right there. That's my guy right there, man. Coming in, making sure I pull that ear down. It's very, very important, man. Any barber out there knows the worst place you can cut somebody is on the ear. It's like, if I feel like it's connected to your heart, because as soon as you cut that thing, it does not stop bleeding no matter what you do. It's going to bleed. Nick powder doesn't matter. That's just something that is going to have to just close on its own in time. Now you see I'm going and I'm doing my detail work. You know, the beginning of the fade was like my rough draft. Now I'm kind of, you know, I'm working on that final copy. I'm about to, you know, turn that thing in, making sure everything is polished, making sure it's smooth, you know, not trying to dig too much, not using the whole blade, but more so the corner of the blade. I'm coming in right here, catching those dark spots that I won't be able to hit with my half guard. Once you understand how to use your tools and the capability of your tools, man, you can do a haircut with any pair of clippers, any kind of comb, man. I'm telling you. As you can tell, that comb was missing teeth. I've had that comb for like 6 years now. That is my baby. Like that clipper, any pair of clippers and that comb, I'm getting a haircut done at a high quality. High quality. It's going to get done. Coming in right now. Again, no guards. Just teasing, catching those dark spots and making sure I'm combing away those loose hairs that has already been cut, so I can have a clear canvas and know exactly what I'm cutting, so I know what steps I got to take next. Then a shout out to my boy Wishlade, man. Looking at bottom left corner, if anybody out there needs some beats, you know, any artists out there, YouTubers, content creators, make sure y'all hit up at Wishlade. That's my best friend, that's my boy, that's my brother. I've been rocking with him since his first beat, so it's only right. I have to use my boy for all my content and stuff like that. In any aspect, I always use my boy Wishlade, so shout out to him. Make sure y'all go show him some love, shoot him a follow, and definitely, you know, support the business, because as you can hear, his beats are definitely slamming. They coming with it for sure. And shout out to Gamma, man. Again, I can't stress enough, like, they are really, like, that company is definitely coming with it this year. I'm a fan of their work. These Ergos are 100% a part of my daily. 100% a part of my daily. If y'all watching this video, I see the bottom of the screen. Like, subscribe, turn those notifications on, leave these comments. Let's share this thing. Let's blow this video up, man. Let's blow this video up. If y'all, and again, leave in the comment section. I want to know what kind of clippers that y'all using on y'all day-to-day basis. How many clippers do y'all have, and what are y'all go-tos? And any suggestions, anything that y'all hear, because that y'all want to see in the future, any type of content that y'all trying to get from me, leave in the comment section, man. I will do my best to try to get back and provide that content that y'all want to see, man. Coming in now, for the most part, it's crazy. Like, a lot of my clients prefer not to have any color or any enhancements in their beards. If you can see on my page, they don't mind it on the hairline, but definitely on the beard, they try to keep it natural, which I'm doing right here. If you see me dragging that blade on the beard, that's something that I got from Our Uppercut a few years ago. That's a nice, easy way to get those loose, like little roach legs or little loose hairs off the beard to get a nice finished look for the haircut. What you do on the one side, got to do to the other side, like my boy Beam always say. You know, I'm keeping that beard as natural as possible. He wanted it high because he's trying to get it, you know, get that full look. Coming in right now with the hairline, pulling that skin back, trying to set my boy up as good as possible, man. As good as possible. Just trying to make sure that hairline is nice and sharp. I don't want it to be too much of an ash line up there, you know, because I still want it to look as natural as possible, even though the enhancements are in there as well. Pulling that skin to create that tension to make those hairs stick up so I can get the cleanest possible look that I possibly can. And then now I'm just cleaning off the forehead for any like excess spritz or got to be glue that's on there or any enhancements that's there. You don't want your client walking out looking like they have, you know, they just left a makeup spot. You know what I'm saying? Clean their face off. Make sure they walking out there looking like a magazine casket ready, man. And shout out to my boy Slick Nicks for the fire cape, man. Again, great quality cape. Great quality cape. So we just doing this detail work, man. I'm really excited to be on this YouTube thing, man. Y'all have no idea how much, like, this motivates me to just to see the reactions and seeing the comments and the support from everybody in the comments on Instagram. I really do appreciate it. I promise y'all I'm definitely coming with it on my page with haircuts, inspiration, lifestyle, vlog, all of that, man. I'm bringing every aspect of the game to my life to this Instagram. And as you can see, this is the before. My dog was looking crazy hurt. But once you sit in my chair, I guarantee one thing. You're going to leave cured with a cured haircut and a cured mindset. The haircut's just a cherry on top. And that's that final look for y'all, man. Clip over comb. No guards used whatsoever on my boy. I hope y'all love it, man. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, share it. Follow up on your boy, because this year, I promise you, I'm coming with bangers. Weekly bangers. And that's my word right there. Y'all be safe. Y'all enjoy y'all.